In this video, I am going to explain anatomical relationship with piriformis and sciatic nerve. Piriformis and sciatic nerve. You know, piriformis is very deep muscle. It is important for hip movement and hip stability. Yep, that's very important for joint. However, if you look at relationship with nervous tissues, that's more important, okay? So, where is sciatic nerve? Sciatic nerve is this nerve. This nerve originates from anterior part of sacrum. Let's say that's from anterior part of sacrum. Many nerves originate from sacrum. It kind of fuses together. Then this nerve runs in front of piriformis. Now, look at here. This nerve shows up from inferior border of piriformis, just about here. Then sciatic nerve runs down below. Okay, that is why this is very famous muscle and nervous tissue relationship. One more muscle I want to focus on. What is this one? This is gemellus superior. Gemellus superior. This muscle is below piriformis. Okay? So when piriformis and gemellus superior gets tight, that can create impingement for sciatic nerve. That can be cause for pain around this area, or maybe numbness, because nervous tissue doesn't like impingement that creates pain and numbness. This is very famous relationship, right? That is why flexibility of piriformis and gemellus superior is crucial. Plus, some researches say sciatic nerve penetrates piriformis, then it runs like this. This is not for everybody, but this can be possible for few people. I don't know about percentage, but this is possible. Sciatic nerve can penetrate piriformis and it can run like this. In that case, flexibility of piriformis is more important because literally nerve runs in piriformis. Does it make sense? Okay, this is one relationship of piriformis and nervous tissue. But there are many other nervous tissue around piriformis. Let me explain them. Again, this is sciatic nerve. There are few more nerves that shows up from inferior part of piriformis. Let's look at this one. This is posterior femoral cutaneous nerve. It's long name. Posterior femoral cutaneous nerve. What does cutaneous mean? That means sensory nerve. This nerve takes information about sensation from posterior part of thigh. Okay, this pink one. This is posterior femoral cutaneous. Okay. Next one. Next one is this one. This is pudendal nerve. Pudendal nerve. This nerve goes to genital area. This nerve is also important. When this part gets chronically compressed, maybe sitting for long time, maybe 6 hours or 8 hours for a day, this nerve can be compressed. Then that can aggravate function of genital area. That's very important, don't you think? This is pudendal nerve. Okay, one more nerve that shows up from inferior part of piriformis. That is this one. This is inferior gluteal nerve. Inferior gluteal nerve. This is also important nerve. Why? Because this nerve innervates gluteus maximus. Gluteus maximus. That is one of the biggest muscles in human body. That is important for hip extension, hip movement, right? Oh my gosh. There are four nerves that emerge from inferior border of piriformis. Sciatic nerve, of course. And posterior femoral cutaneous. Pudendal nerve. This is important for genital area. Last one is inferior gluteal nerve. Holy cow. This is important. And there is one more nerve, but that shows up from superior part of piriformis. Okay, the last one is this one. Okay, this is superior gluteal nerve. Superior gluteal nerve. We just had inferior gluteal nerve. This nerve innervates gluteus maximus. Superior gluteal nerve innervates three muscles. That's gluteus medius. Gluteus medius and gluteus minimus. And last one is tensor fascia lata. Let's say it's TFL. Tensor fascia lata. These three muscles are important for stabilization of hip and pelvis. Of course, they move hip joint and pelvis, but I personally think these three muscles are more important for hip and pelvic stabilization. Okay? Superior gluteal nerve. Okay, I explained five nervous tissues today that have relationship with piriformis. So let's say what happens when piriformis gets tight, or maybe genitalis superior. That can create impingement for this area. How many nerves are there? Four. Then above piriformis there is superior gluteal nerve. That is why tension and flexibility of posterior part of hip joint is very important for nervous tissue relationship. Of course, it's important for hip mobility and hip stability. That's why this part is freaking important place. So in this video, I explained basic anatomical relationship between piriformis and nervous tissue. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.